Minister Chinamasa, thank you for joining us. Africa is the youngest continent, but the majority of young people are unemployed. We're still saying that young people are our asset, these productive young people, but with huge joblessness, are these restless young people now becoming our greatest threat?
Yes, thank you very much. Let me start by thanking SABC for inviting me to this interview, with SABC. But the problem of unemployment among the youths is a very serious one on the continent. In our individual countries, it's a very serious problem. As you are aware, Africa is going to be the continent with the largest portion of youth people, young people, almost 70 to 80% in the next few years. So globally and also continentally, we have a challenge that we have to address by way of securing and taking policies that address the youth unemployment. And the ADBF conference was all about trying to identify strategies that in fact address youth unemployment. The ADB is doing that in all the regional groups, and the conference in Pretoria was to do with Southern African countries. And we put together some ideas, and also we have asked the ADB to identify and the measures that they can take to assist individual African countries to address this problem.
Minister, your country has an unemployment rate reportedly now soaring above 90%. Young people in Zimbabwe are just not working, and we have a huge problem here in South Africa. Can we come up with regional solutions when we can't solve this country by country domestically?
Oh, of course, the strategies to resolve the problem of unemployment domestically at a national level. And when we do it at a national level, would also be collectively resolving the regional problem. And in Zimbabwe, we are addressing this in a multifaceted way. And we have to understand, of course, that we need to find sustainable solutions, because the problem of youth is a recurring one annually. In Zimbabwe, for instance, we have something like 350,000 students who do all levels. Of those, 100,000 go on to tertiary institutions, to university, go on to polytechnics, but the bulk of them, about 250,000 students, fall by the wayside. What therefore it means is that we must find sustainable solutions to resolve and address this issue. And some of the measures we are taking, of course, is to ensure that we have growth in our economy. By growing the cake, by increasing productivity, in that context, we should be able to address some of the issues to do with unemployment. But we are also looking at our education system. We are reviewing, and we've started a new curriculum that is giving focus on science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. This is to create the cadre that is necessary for creating employment. Our education system so far has been to create people who are looking for employment. We now want to create a cadre who should be able to create employment. In other words, we want to create students who are creative, innovative, and who can create employment for others.
Minister,
we are also looking at the big picture.
You need an economy that creates jobs as well, companies that offer jobs. Have you heeded the call of the IMF for huge structural change in Zimbabwe, the warnings that the economy will implode again if the succession debate is not dealt with? Are you speaking to the president about that, for example?
You know we have been imploding. As you know, we have been reported to be imploding for the past 30 years. So we have now, basically, we ignore such messages. They are negative. They will not assist in resolving the problem. We understand our situation. We are under sanctions, as you know. We have no currency of our own, as you know, all because we dared to attack and resolve the land question, which was a colonial issue, and which was the basis of our liberation struggle. So we know why we are in the situation we are. Mm-hmm. But we also understand that the problem cannot be resolved overnight. We need to address issues of skills development amongst our youth so that they are able to create employment for themselves and for others. So as far as we are concerned, we are very clear about our challenges and we are taking measures to overcome those challenges. And we also understand it cannot be resolved overnight. It's a process and we are very clear about that process. And we are taking step by step, laying the foundation for a more permanent solution to our challenges.
Minister, and these problems are not unique
to Zimbabwe alone. There are also other countries which are in that situation.
Minister, one of those challenges is migration to Europe, Zimbabweans to South Africa. So as my final question, can I just ask you if you have any comment on the xenophobic violence that we've seen of late in South Africa?
Yes, I join those peace-loving South Africans who are condemning the phenomenon of xenophobia, the phenomenon of xenophobic attacks by South African hooligans against fellow black Nigerians, Zimbabweans, Mozambicans, and what have you, is something that we should condemn unreservedly. What I think we need to put across is that in colonial times, it has always been the case that the South African economy was stronger than its neighboring economies. It's a situation that we have to address. In other words, we need to address equality in the development of regional economies so that our people will not continue to come to South Africa as they have been doing over the ages. I know my late father, he died in 1952. He worked in South Africa in the 30s and 50s. They helped to develop this South African economy. Now, to change it, it cannot be done overnight, which is why under SADC, under the regional groupings, we are trying to achieve equal development. We are trying also to industrialize so that, in fact, our people can find employment in their own countries. So I want us to understand it as a historical problem, a structural historical problem, where South Africa was the only sound economy, and using the neighboring economies as a source of cheap labor. South African economy was developed by the cheap labor of those people or descendants of those people who are being attacked on South African soil. And it's something that we should condemn.
All right,
the
Minister,
solution is a long-term one.
Minister, thank you very much for your time this evening. And unfortunately, we have to leave it there. I wish we could chat further. That was Patrick Chinamasa, Minister of Finance and Economic Development in Zimbabwe. We take a short break and we'll be back with business news after that.